So now what we're going to work on is our box. So you're going to need these two pieces here. You're going to need your ruler or the lines on your mat. It doesn't really matter. Okay, and these are your pieces. Alright, set these aside. Don't lose them like I already did. You didn't see that I did that, but I did. Okay, so your piece is 8 inches long, your paper is 12 inches long. So, obviously, you want to center this. I've already marked the lines out. You want to put two lines, one on either side, at 2 inches here and 2 inches here. Okay, because you can't see what you're doing in the front. Alright, and at this point too, you want to decide if you want your wood to go that way on the box or this way on the box. Okay, so I am just going to glue this down to the back of this. And this piece is 8 inches by 2.5 inch. That's the front of your box. Okay, so go ahead and glue this down. Sure, I distribute the glue underneath there evenly. There you go. Okay, and don't worry about the edges on this one because we're going to be covering it. Okay, we're going to be covering it with our construction strips, which you will see. Okay, now what I want you to do is I want you to take your 3.5 by 2.5 inch piece, set it against here. Okay, and then I want you to flip this up and burnish it and put a score so that you know where this is going. Just pre-scored in advance, okay? So you're leaving a gap in here. I don't think you're going to be able to see it. But that's why when you score it, you can do it this way too, but it's easier for you to hold, because basically what you're doing is you're just giving it a little extra space and you're pre-folding it. Okay, so when you put this down, I want the 3.5 inch length to be like this. Obviously, you're going to match it up to this, okay? But when you set it in there, I want to make sure you guys can see there's a little tiny little gap there, okay? That's why we're going to hold it like this first, and then we're going to push this up. So then there's no worries, and you know there's going to be a gap in there. I'm going to glue this side, I'm going to glue in here, okay, I'm going to set this in here, this, line it up, the other piece, hold it, flip it up, okay, and then you know that you have that gap there, right? Let's make sure my glue's still wet. It's going to be like that. You can see the chipboard, the way it's lined up. There's your gap. Like that. Okay. And do the same thing on the other side with the other 3.5 inch piece. Now, because again, every cutter is different, make sure you line one of the edges up with the paper. Okay, so if you look here, I have this flush with the paper, and there's some hanging out down here, because you're never going to get an exact cut, okay? You can try. Good luck with that, okay? So again, I'm going to do the same thing on this side. I'm going to give this a quick little burnish in here, so it's already pre-folded. No worries. I'm going to put some glue on here. This, gonna line it up with the other one. Okay, set it like this, and then I'm gonna push it down a little bit like that. Okay, and then I'm gonna let it fall down. And then I'm gonna burnish it really good. Okay. Again, you don't have to worry about it lining up. Okay. I'm more worried with these being lined up on one edge. So as long as this one side is even, you're good to go. If you're gonna trim it, wait till you get all these pieces down. Okay, so if you feel, again, if you didn't get, you have to pick at least one side to be even, because that's gonna be the top part of your box, okay? I'm gonna trim this anyway, just because I have quite a bit hanging off there. Okay, there we go. Okay. So, what we're gonna do now is we're gonna take the other piece. We're going to do the same thing. I've already marked it. You're going to mark it in 2 inches on either side, because it's 12 inches, right? So what you want to do is make sure you put, this is going to be stuck to the box. You're not going to see it, but you are going to see the sides, okay? So, because the sides are going to connect like this. Okay, so you want them to be facing in a certain direction, right? Just so as you know. Okay, so here's my lines. This. Guys, I almost just had a heart attack. I thought my mic wasn't turned on. Okay, set it down. That. Burnish. Now again, you can use any piece of chipboard, okay, and just set it in there and give it a little burnish, okay, and set that mark in there, all right? You still want to have that leeway, all right? And you don't have to fight with it later. So, we have this. And this, okay? So we're gonna flip these pieces in like that, okay? We're gonna glue one side at a time. And now we're about to form the box. So, what I want you to do is push this up against here, line it up, we'll wrap it around. Okay, just let it sit there for a second, and then lay it flat, and I do that just to make sure my little gap's in here, okay? Oops, I got lots of glue in there. Okay. Looks like it was made to be like that, right? See, again, I didn't check, so this wood is going the same way. So you know what? I wonder if I can get this off of here. Doubt it. Let's see, I think I'm good. Yes. Okay. Don't do what I did. Turn it around. Okay, let's try this again. Good recovery, Monica. Good recovery. Okay. Jeesh. Okay, let's try this again. Let's hang this in here. Like that. Stick that in like that. That's the way I want. And then I'm gonna write down. Burnish it really good. Squish all the glue around. That's what I wanted to see. See that? Jeesh. See, again, this is why you want to make sure you got it going the right way. Because you want the wood to look the same. You know what I mean? Okay, you guys know what I mean now. Alrighty. the last side here and pull a little bit of this up. Okay. Because I don't want little bumpies under there. Okay. Phew. What a recovery I made there, eh? I was not doing that part of this tutorial over again, I can tell you that. This paper is like gold. Okay, so see what I did? I fit it up against there. And I wrapped it around. Okay, and this is basically your box now. So, the last piece, you're going to have to stand up. And you're going to have to burnish it while it's standing up. I know you guys can't see this. Sorry, you'll figure it out, I'm sure. You're all smart cookies. I know this. Okay. There we go. Okay. All right. So that's the box. Now, what I did not put on this, and I'm going to tell you why in a minute. If you look at all of these pieces, you're not going to find a bottom of the box, okay? There's the lid. I know what size that's going to be. There's the front of the album. This is underneath, okay? And here's your last piece of chipboard. Now, the reason I did this is because, again, you guys are all going to put this together a different way. Okay? The corners might not match up. You might have just laid it down. You may have done what I just did and you can't recover it, and now it's kind of bigger or smaller than it's supposed to be. So, what I do when I do bottoms of boxes is I always wait to see what turns out, okay? So, what I do is I take the outside of the box that I'm creating, and I basically push it up against the chipboard, any piece of chipboard. Again, you can use scrap chipboard, but you may as well use the fourth piece here, all right? And I'm gonna have it so that this is on the inside. So I want this piece that I'm gonna cut out on the inside. It's just when I put the construction strips on, it's going to give it that much more stability. It's going to stop the box from rocking and moving and everything else. Okay, so pardon my view at this point, my head might get in the way. I'll stand up. So here I'm lining this up, okay, and it's also going to make it square because this piece of chipboard is square, right? And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to hold this. So it's nice and square, and then I'm going to mark in here, okay, and I'm going to mark over here, okay, and these are just temporary marks, don't use those because chipboard warps and it does funny things, right? So you're going to get your ruler out, and you draw a straight line. I'm lining it up with, I use my quilting ruler so I can see the line I've drawn on the other side here through. I know you guys can't see it. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to line that up and then I'm going to draw a straight line across. Okay, so that's where I'm going to cut this. And I'm also going to do this side here. I should open this way. Okay. And I'm going to put my pencil down first. And pretty good. Okay, so this is going to be the inside of my box. Alright, so I'm going to get my knife and I'm going to cut that out right now. This piece too. Now, highly recommend it if you guys want to cover the inside of this box. Okay, do it now. Save yourself the hassle. Just do the way I showed you. Put the glue on, put it on the paper, whatever color paper you want, and cut it out. Make sure you do it from behind. And yeah, I am going to paint the inside of this box, so I'm not worried about it. All right. So now what you want to do, again, dry fit. Make sure that this little piece fits into the bottom of your box. And it does. Okay, so that's going to make it rigid. That's going to make it sturdy. That's going to hold it in place and keep it square. All right. Look at that. Okay. Now, guys, to get these out. Okay. Now we know that this box is 8 inches. Okay, so these are 1 inch. All right. So on the outside of the box, you're gonna need 8 and a bit because of the way we put the chipboard. Okay, so the best thing to do is just basically measure it after you do it. Alright, so we know for this box, so the way I'm going to do it is I'm going to score it in half, and then it's going to look like this. Okay, so you're going to have a half inch score. Again, you can use the white paper if you wanted to. I think I'm going to use this paper. I like it better. And I found that the white paper here is pretty thin. You can use it if you want. You might not have enough though. One, two, three, four. I don't think you're going to have enough to do the whole box. Oh, maybe. What do you think? Maybe I'll try it. Forget that. Okay, so I'm gonna get my scoreboard out and I'm gonna score 4 of these at a half an inch. So I have 4 of these. Now these here, you definitely, before you do anything else, you do not want to be using marker with this, so I'm going to get my ink out right now. I'm going to use that ink. And I think that is the ink for that. Okay, and I'm going to put my score tape down first. Again, you can use your art glitter glue, but I find that it's much easier for construction strips to use score tape. So that is what I am using. So you put score tape on the outside on your center score line. Okay. So you do that and finish all 4 of these. Okay, so now we can burnish these. Okay, and now I'm going to ink them. Inking those, I'm putting this ink far away from my project so I don't pooch it out. Okay, and then I'm gonna take all of my construction strips that I have and I'm just gonna fold them over and I'm gonna burnish them. construction strips. Alright. I gotta tell you, kudos to Echo Park / Gardabella paper manufacturers, because this paper's pretty good. Right? It's not cracking or anything. I don't know where you guys live, whoever's watching, but if it's dry, I don't even think you're gonna have to wet this down. Because it's not cracking. Bonus! Okay, so here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna take this piece and do the sides first, or the front and the back first, okay? I'm gonna take it, I'm gonna hold it down. Actually, I'm gonna get my scissors here. My second favorite scissors. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna cut it off. Okay. So there's one. Okay. Obviously the front is gonna be the same size, you hope. I mean, I know mine is, just in case here, we'll do this. Okay. Like that. Okay. Corner to corner. And don't forget to ink the edge that you cut off. And you may as well do this one before you forget. Just in case. You're going to be using these. Okay. So that's inked. So, I'm going to lay this down first. Alright. My inside, the bottom, is not attached yet, obviously. But it's helping to hold this box together. Alright? It's just in there loose. But it's snug, so it's not flopping around like a fish out of water. Okay, I'm gonna take this off, and then I'm going to align this up. I know it's gonna be perfect, because I just got it to be perfect. Okay. And stick it down. Inside pieces there, your box isn't going to collapse, so you can give it a little bit of a burnish like that. Okay, once you flip it over and do the other side now the same way. Now, see, I must have got them mixed up, and everybody's box is different. There's a little bit hanging over, and because I have OCD, I am going to snip that off. It again. And I'm gonna set it down. There we go. Okay. So take this. I'm gonna set it down there. I'm gonna burnish it down. Now, if you're in a drier climate, or you have massive climate change like we do here in Ontario, I'm just going to pop this out of here, and I'm going to burnish this box on the inside, too, to help this stick, okay? Because tomorrow it could be summer here, and then the next day it could be winter here. We don't know. It's still winter. 10 days of spring, I think, but okay. That's that. Then I'm going to take these little pieces that I cut off, and I'm going to stick these onto the sides as well. Okay. So I'm going to measure it out. All right. Now see what a mess this is when this isn't in here. So no matter, I'm going to stick this back in. You can actually stick it down if you want to. Let's do that first. So I'm peeling this off. Okay, I'm going to do both sides at once so I don't have to mess with it. Okay. And then I'm going to push it out a little bit. I don't want it to stick right away. Okay. I'm going to fold this down. Alright. Let me do this. And do this. Over, I'm going to push it down, and then I'm going to push this down on the inside. And that just made my life easy. Okay. That is these in the end, so I'm going to do this. Again, I'm going to trim it just like I did the first one. And I'm going to mess that up. Okay. I'm going to check the sides. Don't forget to ink. Now, I'm going to ink this at the corner just in case for some reason you can see that. Okay, and then I'm also going to ink where I cut. Alright. Stick this down here. I'm going to just finish this side off and then flip it around like that, and it's stuck down. And I'm going to put a burnish. Okay. See? I like that. Looks nice. Okay. Piece. So I'm gonna take this like that, and I'm gonna cut this piece here. Again, devil is in the details, people. So you want to make sure. What makes projects, that's what sets it apart from the rest, okay? You just make sure everything is even steven there. Okay, I'm gonna ink this edge. I think I'm good here. Yeah, I don't see anything there. Okay. I'll set that up there so I don't ink up any white paper that's lying around. It happens. I'm going to line this up now for the last piece here, because once I've, look, when you're lining up your corners, okay, again, everything changes, everything's different. If you didn't fold this exactly, one side could be different or bigger than the other, like this piece here, okay? So I'm going to make this my back. I'm going to go back to this side, and I'm going to make sure that these two corners are lined up perfectly, because I think it looks better like that. Okay. So I'm going to go like this. Sorry if you can't see. Okay. So that and that are lined up perfectly. This and this are lined up perfectly. Burnish it down. And now I can turn the corner like that. Okay. And now I'm going to lightly burnish this because it's not attached in there yet. Alright, and then I'm going to flip it over and I'm going to give it another really good burnish on the inside here. Okay. Now here's where you have to decide. Now I like the look of this, okay? I am going to do the top as well, okay? You don't have to do the top as well, it's up to you. I'm going to paint the inside, but I'm not going to do this right now. I'm not going to paint the inside right now because then it will take forever to dry, right? So basically, if you want to do the top as well, you do the exact same thing, but when you're doing the inside, when you measure, you don't measure on the outside of this, okay? You measure on the inside, alright? And then you snip it on the inside. So, don't, it's not gonna fit in there. Okay. Like that. So see, that's the look I am going for. So I inked it, you're not gonna see it. This can go in here. I can paint the inside of my box, but I don't wanna stick these down right now because, like I said, I'm gonna paint and I want it to be in there, painted even and dry. So, okay, where I left off was I had cut all the edges off of here. Sorry, I have a bit of a stuffy nose. And what I did is I painted, instead of covering with paper, the inside of this potting bench. Okay, so I painted that, I let it dry, and then I stuck down my construction strips to all four sides. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to do the next thing we're going to do is we're going to take the lid for the box, okay, and the lid is 3 3/4 by 8 inches, okay. Now, I decided, and we'll just do a little review here. So, I decided to use the white paper. I think the white is going to look pretty cool on here. Oh, actually, hold on. I'm going to take off the autofocus because it's bugging me. Okay. So, I've decided to put the lid white. Okay. You guys can do whatever you want. If you have 2 paper packs, you can probably use this paper as well. It's up to you guys. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna move that out of the way. So this is my lid, and I'm going to cover the lid, okay? And I'm going to use my art glitter glue for this. I'm gonna make sure before I start wrestling with it, that out a little bit. Okay, so I'm gonna get this. I'm gonna get my tool that I'm gonna use to spread it all around, and I am going to cover this with glue. Now again, you can use score tape, whatever you prefer. And use the glue if you don't want the lumpies. You gotta act kind of fast and just make sure you push everything around and don't be scared. Okay, and I'm gonna line it up like that. Okay, set it down. Spread my glue out. Okay, and you wanna make sure that you're covering the edge. We're gonna ink the edges anyway. At least I'm gonna ink the edge. Okay, I'm gonna get my glue off of here. Uh oh, let's see. I didn't do it close enough. Okay, let's try this again. Just made it in time. I had it turned the wrong way and couldn't see it. Okay, there we go. So we can do this again. I'm just making sure that I'm completely covering the lid with the paper. Twice now. Okay. I'm gonna flip it over and make sure I spread that glue out before it dries. Okay. Okay. Take my craft knife. As a guide. Okay. And I'm going to trim it right next to the chipboard. Okay. Like that. So now we have this. Oops. Okay. Now, because you're using glue and it's chipboard, and it's pretty porous, it would seem that it sucks up the glue quite a bit. I'm going to take this and I'm going to set it aside and I'm going to put it under a book. So give me 1 second. So as the glue dries, it'll hold it down so it doesn't warp on you. Alright? So the next thing we're going to do is we're going to take these two pieces. They're 3 inches by 1 inch. Okay? And we're going to score them at a half an inch. Now the way I score them is I use my paper trimmer. Okay? And I use a blade. I have a blade in here. Hold on 1 second. If I can find it. And my pack of blades. So these are all used blades, but I use them. They're still sharp and they're good for cutting chipboard, okay? So that's what I'm gonna do. So I'm gonna switch this out right now. And I use these because the blade doesn't go all the way through this chipboard and it leaves a perfect score mark. Okay. So I'm gonna set it in the middle. Blade in first. And that makes it so that you can bend it and it still holds it together for you. Okay. So you're gonna do that to both of these pieces. Give me 1 sec, guys. I gotta take my sweater off. I'm having a hot flash. Okay, sweater's off. Now, I'm gonna take one of my strips that I cut out of the paper, and that was in part one. Okay, and what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna glue it down just to show you. Two different ways of doing it. You can cut this strip in half, but I'm not going to do that right now. I've already pre-scored it, so I'm just going to do this. Okay. I'm going to glue that right on there like that. Oops. Okay. Next one. Okay. Now, right now you're asking yourself, why didn't she just do that with the paper? Put the paper on first and then score it. Well, I'm going to tell you why. Because if you put the paper on first, paper is just too thick, and when you score it, it does not bend easy. Okay, so you're gonna be fighting with it. It's gonna, trust me, we're gonna rescore it again. But if you do it this way, it'll fold perfectly, and you're not gonna have any issues because the blade's gonna go deep enough into the chipboard to make it fold really good. Okay, that is why I did that, because I know you guys are probably saying, why didn't she do that? So, 9-0. Okay. Now, if you feel like you're really lucky, you can just use your blade and do that, but I'm just going to stick it back in here again. Okay. And I'm going to do it again. Okay. There. And now, see how it folds? Because we're going to, either you can run your marker in here, you can ink it up. I'll just show you. Like I did in the first one, I just ran my marker in around everything, right? Okay. So, because this is going to be showing, so you're going to want to do this. Now you can bend it all the way and you can ink it as well. It's complete. completely up to you. Use your Tim Holtz inks. Probably do that to the outside of this, maybe. Just to show you. Okay, so those are my legs. Now, we can do the outside as well. And I'll just show you. You could have easily done that. I'm going to see if I like the color here. Oh yeah, that looks pretty good. So there you go. Okay. Looks pretty good. So, want to make sure we ink all the way around on this. Because you're going to see the edges. Okay. Your marker, but I get a little too tedious with the marker, so I'm just going to use my ink right now. Okay, now you're not going to see the back. If you wanted to, now would be a good time to either put another piece of paper on, or you can use a marker, or you can ink it, or do whatever you want. Just if you're a little neurotic like that, so I'm just going to do this so it makes it a little darker. Okay. You're not really going to see it, but just in case if you have it up on a shelf or something, it's always nice to finish things off. It's the little things that count, right? Okay, so we're gonna let the ink on that dry because that's my Stampin' Up! Ink and it'll stay pretty wet. Lost the pin. There it is. Put this pin back in here for now. Okay, so what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna cover. Now, we're gonna do the lid. I think it's been drying long enough. Yes. Okay, so I'm gonna do the lid now and also pull these strips out. I'm gonna cover the other side, okay, with the lid just so you can see your options. So then you don't have to say, oh, I should have done it that way. So if you recall from video number one, we measured in 2 inches on either side. Okay, to line it up. Okay, so I am going to cover the other side. This and line it up with my lines that I just marked with my pencil. And that'll be the center. Okay. Flip it over. Spread the glue around. Now I have a choice. See. Okay, I'm gonna wipe off a little bit of glue that's in there. Trim this up. So, I'm going to give you guys a little preview and let's see how it looks. So, your lid, obviously, you're going to mount your lid to the box before you glue it down. So, now would be the time to make the decision whether or not you want, you want the white lid or this lid. I did not leave it on the under that book long enough. Okay. So completely up to you guys. Now would be a good time to decide what you're gonna do. I like that. Might have to go with that. Okay, I'm gonna leave this aside still. Okay. And also at this point, so you can either ink your edges here or you can go around it because you have enough construction strips right now with this to do this. So I'm gonna do this. Where's my scoreboard? Okay. Now that the phone is done ringing, scoreboard out, and I'm going to get my favorite scoring tool, and I'm going to score this piece at 1/2 inch, and I'm going to score one more piece at 1/2 inch. Okay, don't need this one yet. Okay. Now, I'm going to show you how I did it in the other one. Okay, so see here, I just put the strip on the back and then I inked the edges. So once you ink it, it looks pretty good. So this is totally optional. You don't need to use this. If you wanted to save that for inside of your album or something, feel free. Okay. Before I forget, I'm gonna change the blade back out. That's my good blade. I don't want to shred my paper. That would suck. Right? So I'm going to put score tape on this. I need 3/8 of an inch score tape here. Again, you can use glue if you want. Completely up to you. Favorite little tool gone. It's gone forever. I think Tamara was here and hid it on me. I'm gonna blame it on Tamara because she probably won't have time to watch this video, so it's all your fault, Tamara. You guys can tell where I blamed her. Again, it doesn't really matter where you put the score tape on this one. I put it right on the outside of this one to go around the box because I prefer that that part sticks. You can run a bead of glue down here once you attach it to the one side, and I'll show you. So what we're going to do is we're going to do these three sides first, okay, because we're going to attach the back one onto the box. Before we do that, I'm going to put these around. So there we go. So I'm going to do the front first, and then I'm going to do the two sides. Alright. So I'm just holding it up, and then I'm cutting it the same, pretty much the same length. Not really quite. And now I have a more exact one for this. trim this off of here. So this one I'm going to save for the back. Let's get rid of this garbage. Now, I think I'm going to do the sides first. So I'm just going to fold this over. Okay. And what I can do is stick this on here. And as you can see, it's a little warped. So I can go ahead and go back and I'm going to put this under a book later where you can just give it a little bend. Alright? So that's a little straighter. Right. That. Okay. So I'm going to finish this on. And then this is what I'm saying, where you put a little bit of glue in here so you get full coverage. Fighting with me. There we go. Okay. There we go. That's good enough there. This side. Shine this way first. Because I am still undecided as to what I'm going to put on here. Sorry, I'm going to smack the mic there with my big bottle. Guess we'll know in a minute what we're gonna do. Okay. I don't know, people. I don't know if I like this way for the lid. There's the box part. This way. I'm still undecided. Okay, I'm gonna cover one more side and maybe that'll make the difference. So I'm gonna make sure it's the right length here. Yep. This could be the decision maker for me right here. Throwing fits on me right now. Still undecided. I don't know, people, I think I like this better. Yeah, I think I like that better. Yep, I'm going with this one. Okay, so your last piece. Okay, well, let's fold it over first. Give it a good burnish. Now, I am going to trim this right now. Now, the lid for your box actually sits, you can see right here, it's not all the way across this box. It actually fits. It's just more visually appealing. It's the exact same size as the back, and then the sides will stick out a little bit. Okay? So, just so you know, we're lining this up and we're gonna have a little bit peeking out on either side here. Okay? Not much. Just a little bit. Yeah, I definitely want that. So I'm going to use my lid. I'm going to just trim it to the sides of the lid right now. Okay. This is brunch pretty good too. Like this. I'm gonna stick it to the back. Okay, and see how it's gonna stick out on the front. Okay, that is how it is supposed to look. Make sure it's even on both sides here. Stick it down. Once I get it started, I'm good. Okay. So I'm just gonna do a little like that. Then I'm gonna open it up and I'm gonna burnish it really, really good from the inside. Okay, so I'm just pushing down here. Now again, you can take a marker or whatever. This and I'm just gonna run it in here. I don't have to, I mean, it's not imperative, but it's the little things sometimes that make a project, right? Like that. So when you open it, it's not gonna open all the way anyway. But you're not really going to see that now. It just takes away from the shiny white. Okay. So, we've got our legs now. And they should be dried out. The ink should be dried anyway. Right? So what we're going to do is, I'm going to set this down here. You can glue this now, but just in case, you better not. Because you want your legs to attach onto the corners of your box. Okay? So this is where you decide where you want your box. Okay. So it's going to set like that. And that's going to support the front part. So if you want this flush with this, the way I have it in the other one. Right. Set it there. And you can even do a measurement and then draw a line if you want. So this is how I'm going to do this. I'm just lining this up. So I lined the box up where I wanted it. So I want a little bit of the white to show. Right? And the box up, slide this underneath, and you want this to be level at the bottom here. Okay, and then put a little pencil mark. You can get some mud over there. Now I'm going to put a little pencil mark like that. So on here, I have a pencil mark. And again, I do it this way because everybody has their own preference, and sometimes people cut things and you can always recover from it. It's not an exact science, right? So I am going to just make this line all the way across here. Hold on. Just so I can see it. And then I'm going to make the same line on the other one so that they're perfectly even. Okay. There goes pencil lead again. Alright. So now what I want you to do is take your box, let it lay down like that, and you are going to put this exactly, you're going to put glue on here, and you're going to put it on the corner. And you're going to make sure that your little lines, oh my gosh, can you guys see that? There's a line, you can see it there. Okay, so you want to line the line up at the bottom of your box. Okay, so I'm going to do that right now. Okay, so now I have that part done. And what I'm going to do, so I can see and you guys can see, I am just going to, okay, it's hard, I don't know how I'm going to describe this to you, so just set it like that, okay, if I had a level, I would actually drop a level on this, so, you want to have it so that, because remember I said the lid is the exact size, oh there, you can see it there, there's a little bit of the size of the box showing, that's what you want, okay, so basically just line it up, set it down, because the back underneath, it acts as the back legs. Okay, so you want to make sure it's level and it's even, and it will find its own place. I am just going to do a little, I'm going to put a little pencil line here, and then I'll measure it for you guys. Okay, so the bottom of the box will be an inch and 3/4 from the bottom. So that is where I want you to draw a little light pencil line right there. Okay? And that is where the bottom of your box is going to be. Okay, people, so again, that is an inch. Let's make sure I got the right ruler here. An inch and 3/4 from the bottom. Draw your line, and that is where you are going to stick your box down. Now, you can use glue. You can use score tape, use whatever you want. Just make sure you got it even on both sides before you stick it down. Okay? So I'm going to turn it this way so I can see. And I'm just going to check the back and make sure. Yep, pretty even there. And then before it dries completely, I'm going to set it down. And just give it a little wiggle and make sure that it's fairly even. So now I can wipe off this excess glue here. Okay. Make sure there's no glue where the lid is, because if there is any, it might attach to the hinge you've put on the lid, and it might prevent you from opening the box properly. Okay, so now I'm going to reach inside here with my little tool. You can just use your hand and just kind of, if you don't have any kind of a burnishing tool, and I'm just going to give it a little push down like that so that glue distributes evenly, and then I'm going to check the back now, and I'm going to wipe off any excess glue. It dries clear, so it's not a big deal, but I'm going to wipe that off. I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to paint the back of this later. Okay. And now your bench will stand on its own, and you have your lid. Okay. And that is the bench part done. Okay. So I'm going to set this aside to dry for now. And I'm going to find something heavy to put in here, and we'll come back with part 3. Okay, guys, thanks for watching, and see you in part 3. Bye.